kingdom to Israel. He replied, it's not for you to know the time or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had entered the city, they went into the room upstairs where they were staying. Peter and John, James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer, together with certain women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, as well as his brothers. Here ends the reading. We shall now chant Psalm 68, found on page 244.
Lesson is from the fourth chapter of 1 Peter.
Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that is taking place among you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice insofar as you are sharing Christ's sufferings, so that you may also be glad and shout for joy when his glory is revealed. If you are reviled for the name of Christ, you are blessed, because the Spirit of glory, which is the Spirit of God, is resting on you. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Discipline yourselves. Keep alert. Like a roaring lion, your adversary, the devil, prowls around looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in all the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. And after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To him be power forever and ever. Amen. Here ends the reading.
Young at heart, they've come forward. how today we are one. First God gave Jesus to us. You're a strong young man. Can you break that? Easy to do. That group, you think you can break that? Pretty hard to do. Yeah, so you're not going to be able to because it's a grouping. We are one. A single stick comes apart pretty easily. But we as a church family, together, a strength that you cannot believe. So, when we are together, seems to be some advantages to that, doesn't it? Yeah. That's the message that we have heard over the years. And you know how you put things back together? This way. And you'll see through time, going back to the teachings of Jesus, to where we are today, strength comes from being together. You know, I've seen your young men as you've been growing as these years have gone by. What do you do when you need guidance, assistance? Prayer. Right? Because your family is greater than one. And then you can expand that to the lives that we live here in our church. Because the church isn't the brick and the mortar. It's everyone. It's us as persons. It's an amazing story, that story of Jesus, because God gave him to us to help set direction, and we who come together express our faith together. Strength in numbers. So that's something that we want to carry with us all the time. Not everyone is able to make it to church every Sunday. You probably can still be a good Christian, but again, the strength comes from when we're together in numbers. We are one. So thank you for being here. It's good to see you. I see you guys often. That's important. Thank you. So, how do we take that from our youth to us as adults, or becoming adults? I think with this being Memorial Day weekend, I see it a lot in the history of our beautiful nation. Because many came together when times were dark. And those men gave it all for us. That's a grouping that when they were one, they were unstoppable. And they helped point our world in the right direction again. Now, nothing's perfect. There are still challenges every day. And you've heard me from the pulpit in the past mention that I always look forward to Mondays. I especially look forward to tomorrow because that's where we will recognize those who have gone before us that worked so hard, gave it all. But it's a constant. We should never forget. We should always remember. That's what Jesus taught us the disciples. You know, that was, those are challenging times as Jesus was really leaving this world. He entrusted those disciples to carry the message. The message that these so many thousand years later we have. We come together as one. Now, we have so many opportunities every day to share the word of Jesus, to be kind, to be respectful. And I want us to all practice those because it's really not hard. And in fact, it becomes quite rewarding. There's nothing better than sharing the message. We all have our unique styles, and that's okay. We have a great value. The faith we're able to express to others from our hearts and our heads is a gift. It really is a gift. So as we go forward into this tomorrow and the next week, remember the simple message that we are one. Together,